Did Stranger Things Season 2 exceed expectations? I'm David Griffin, and here's what I thought. Some minor spoilers to follow. Any show's first season doesn't guarantee that the writers can replicate what they did before. With prestige comes the added pressure and expectation to not only equal, but surpass what you did the previous year, hence the phrase, sophomore slump. So, did the second season live up to all the hype? I'm thrilled to say that Stranger Things Season 2 is a rousing success, which builds upon its already incredible cast and expertly expands the world of Hawkins into the same stratosphere of other great television epics like Game of Thrones and The Walking Dead. The writers do a marvelous job of adding depth to their ensemble by boldly exploring their post-traumatic stress as a direct result of the events surrounding the Upside Down. Right from the beginning, we know that there's something not quite right with Will. Noah Schnapp, who was relegated to another dimension for most of season one, gives a breakout performance. A new year at school wouldn't be the same without new students to fill its halls. Maxine, or Max as she likes to be called, gives the boys a run for their money. Sadie Sink's performance is beyond her years and makes her a welcomed addition to the cast. Her stepbrother Billy is another story. Without going into massive spoiler territory, let's just say his character is the weakest of the bunch and the slowest to develop. Thankfully, Millie Bobby Brown's return as 11 doesn't suffer in the slightest. It's difficult to say anything about her arc without revealing too much, but there are fascinating new places for her to go and people to meet this season. But what about that big monster featured on all the posters and trailers? Yeah, so this new threat makes last year's Demogorgon look like a cute bunny rabbit. The Shadow Monster is the main antagonist, and he's a formidable foe. Even with all of its strengths, Stranger Things Season 2 is not without its faults. And there are moments when abrupt shifts in tone hurt certain episodes. More specifically, in episode 5, entitled Dig Dug, the show quickly turns into a joke fest, resulting in the most unbalanced hour of the season. Don't worry, the show gets better from there. If it isn't apparent already, Stranger Things Season 2 was a joy to watch. Even in its weaker moments, there are still excellent performances from both new and returning cast members. The Duffer Brothers kept everything you loved about season one and built a bigger, better version of the series that won't leave you feeling disappointed. Thanks for watching. For more on Stranger Things, check out our breakdowns of Easter eggs and moments you may have missed in each episode. And make sure to like and subscribe to IGN everywhere you like to watch.